When I made a snake oil video, well, one of my first snake oil videos about the smart EQ from Sonneball, I actually was pretty surprised. It was almost like the EQ knew what I was about to do. I was so surprised by this EQ, it's no wonder that Sonneball has reached out to me with their new version of the smart EQ, the smart EQ 2. I am Wietse, and let's see if the smart EQ 2 is snake oil. All right, so since I'm recording this video before this smart EQ 2 actually is being released, I don't have a website to look at. So we have to look at a small document I got with it to check the features so we can check the snake oilness of them. If we look at the key features of it, it's an 8-band linear phase software EQ, and here's the interesting thing, with the built-in AI algorithm. Well, the original one also had AI, but they've improved it a lot. You now have a self-learning high-precision filter band. So state-of-the-art filter types, content-aware processing, smart filter automation, and mid-side EQing. It's really good at detecting resonances with unprecedented precision. You know, that resonances thing, everybody's talking about detecting resonances and removing them out of your audio. I don't really get what the deal is. Sometimes I have to deal with resonances, but it's not that big of a deal, actually. And it's also not a lot of work to remove them by hand. So what's the thing with those resonances? It can transform into your digital mixing assistant for repetitive EQing tasks, which is nice. They say it's the fastest EQing workflow. It's also handy to use as a second opinion. That's also what I use my analyzer for. If I'm hearing something and I'm not 100% sure, I'm checking it on my analyzer to see if that thing says the same. They just say it's an all you could wish for modern go-to EQ. So let's see, maybe this thing can replace my FAP filter. Maybe it can. I think they also redesigned the user interface. So let's get it booted up. As always, this is also the first time that I'm seeing this thing. Again, I'm using a track called Sandstorm by The Root. All right, so let's get started. This is how it looks like when it's doing nothing. So this is an EQ. And pretty much like FAP filter. Double clicking is moving it. Oh, so these are my EQ bands over here. So that's pretty nice. So we've got a high pass and a low pass filter. Oh, it's a very, very intuitive interface this is. This is really, to be honest, I've never used this before. And it's already pretty easy. So, flat, so we can put it on flat. This is our smart band. As you can see, this goes in strength, in percentages, and not in decibels. And that's because, well, you first have to measure it. So let's measure. There it goes. It's listening to the music and it makes a curve accordingly. So now it's done. And this is difficult to explain. So with this green band, what I can do is I can adjust the amount of correction that I want to have from the algorithm. So if I say, like, I want to have 100% at 1 kHz with a pretty wide, well, Q factor, I will get this curve. So like that. But what I can also do is do it the opposite way. So I can also go a minus percentage. So actually go the other way around. So if the computer says, I want this curve, I can say, no, I want the exact opposite. So I can do it in a negative way. So make it even worse than it already was, if you can say it like that. And we can put up the width to 100%. And then pull out the curve we actually want to have. Or only on the lows, only on the highs. Like, I also reviewed that Gullfoss thing, and that had two filters, I didn't show that in the video actually, but that thing had two filters, like from the left and from the right, so that you can influence it somehow. But the way you can influence the Sonneball curve, it keeps amazing me. To be honest, it's still a bit messing with my brain, because it's not what you're used to doing on an EQ, like working with percentages of an algorithm. That's really, like, difficult to understand. So there's one thing that is a bit annoying me right now in this EQ. So there's a downside. Do I still have the... No, I don't have the original anymore. I really thought I had. But I think the installer upgraded it. So I cannot check this one for sure anymore. But I think that the original... You can have several smart bands. I'm not really sure about that, but the thing that's annoying me, what if I only want to correct the low and the high? So like not correcting the mid. I can only do it like this. So it would be nice to have several of these smart bands so that you can only use it on the places where you want to use it actually. But yeah, that smart feature still is nice. I'm going to run it on a kick drum as well a bit later, but I first want to check out the rest of the plugins. So another thing that's new in here are states. I think what this is that you can record, like if I record from here, I'm getting a different curve. And I think that's what a state is. Yeah, I was right. Yeah. So you can also like learn it on different places in your music and then switch the state of the smart filter. I know this is a bit difficult to explain, but I think you guys can see what's going on my screen. So that's cool. And we can also like pre-learned curves. I don't really understand why you should use these things. Just let the algorithm decide it, because it also depends on how it's recorded and stuff. But it's interesting to look at these curves too. Does it have a kick drum in here? Kick drum. It's interesting to look at these curves if you want to learn more about basic EQing. That's really interesting. Again, here's a kick drum. And you're seeing the same smiley face that I also talked about in a different video, which is linked over here. There are a lot of, you know, interesting things about different instruments, and if you want to know more about EQing those things, you can walk through these profiles. I'm not sure if I would use it, because it really depends on the song you're working on, and it really needs fine tuning per song. So one more thing that I want to do with the Smart EQ is run it through a kick drum, or run it on a kick drum. I want to use it on this kick drum because this kick drum is pretty shitty, and I want to see what it does on this kick drum. So let me play this kick. I don't really know what I'm doing right now, but doesn't really seem that it is understanding what I want. To be honest, it is tightening it up a bit, although I don't like the correction on the low. And the only thing that I also want in here is I want to clean up that beep in the highs. Where's the analyzer? Analyzer. Ah, pre. Like that. Like that. Makes it much nicer. Let's compare. That's pretty good actually. I'm not sure if I should be expecting the Smart EQ to actually detect that beepy thing in that kick. I'm not sure if that's within what it's designed for. But again, I'm expecting a lot from artificial intelligence. So yeah. Another thing that I've noticed is, well, look at the CPU consumption on the kick. It's super low, which is nice. If you're running on a laptop or something, you just want to get the most out of your resources, and using a thing like the Smart EQ won't really be efficient with your resources, unless you're using the Smart EQ version 2, of course. So, end conclusion. Is the Smart EQ 2 snake oil? I think what is going on here is that, you know, the artificial intelligence thing is a big buzzword in marketing. But we're still at the start of what's possible with artificial intelligence. It did detect very good curve for my kick, a curve that I would have used in the mix. So there's still a lot of things to improve with artificial intelligence, and I'm really looking forward to that future. But the Smart EQ version 2 is actually, I think, at at the boundaries of what's possible right now. So, I will link it below. It's not an affiliate link. They offered me an affiliate link, but I want to stay as independent as I am. So, just check it out below and try it out yourself and draw your own conclusions from that. I really want to thank the guys from Sonobol for sending me this plugin before its release date so that I can make a video on the release date, which is pretty awesome. I also want to thank you guys for watching this video. So, if you like this video, let me know with a thumbs up. Leave a comment below with ideas for future videos or other plugins that I should review. Also, if you want to support me, check out my Patreon campaign over here, which is a great way to support me. And another way to support me is watching more videos. So I will link one of those over here. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye.